invite Dr. Erilasan sir to take over.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Priya. This time, Dr. Perumal will do the honor to Dr. Nizar Ahmed. Dr. Perumal, there?
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Sir, please, over to you, sir.
Dr. Nishar Ahmed has been selected for this month's Lifetime Achievement Award. I will read the citation now. Lifetime Achievement Award on this day, the 26th September 2021, this citation is awarded to Dr. Muhammad Nizar Ahmed for his outstanding contribution to society in the field of medicine. An alumnus of the Stanley Medical College, he was awarded MBBS in 1977. He has 43 years of overall experience in general practice at his clinic located at Kundathur and Thousand Lakes. He is also attached to BRS Hospital, Nungambakkam, Chennai. Since COVID-19 pandemic started, daily he did over 50 to 60 video consultation, which brought some sort of satisfaction and pressure both to himself and to the patients. His main area of interest is in pediatric and diabetology. He attended several national conferences. His motto is to continue service to the public as long as he can. He also extends his free services in treating poor students with free consultation of free medicines also. He conducted free camps during the Chennai floods in 2015. He personally participated in many free dental camps along with his daughters who are both MDS general dental surgeons. He does free consultation at Dustling Stone Orphanage, Srikakulam, Kundathur, and home for poor boys at Anna Sali, Chennai. He is a life member of our IMA Chennai Kodambakkam branch. We, the president, the members of the Indian Medical Association Chennai Kodambakkam branch, feel proud to honor a doyen in medical field. Thank you.
Dr. Ahmed is a very simple person, has been doing a lot of social work. So we take immense pressure, sir, in inviting Dr. Ahmed. Is he under spotlight, sir?
Yes, sir.
Dr. K.S., sir, can you bring... Yes, sir. Dr. K.S., would you like to add anything?
No, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
Please. Yes. Sir, over to Dr. Ahmed.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Nizar Ahmed.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
You are invited to speak a few words, sir. Spread your time, sir. Please, yes, talk to us.
Good evening. I welcome all my fellow doctors. I am highly thankful to Indian Medical Association Kodambakkam branch for selecting me for this award. I am thankful to my parents who got me admission to medicine. I was graduated from Stanley Medical College, one of the prestigious and oldest colleges in Tamil Nadu. I must say, it was the luckiest batch to have an excellent teachers in all the practices. During our undergraduate course, our exposure to clinical science was there. I was very much...
You are not very audible. Can you come closer, sir? I'm sorry. Can you be a little closer? Yes, to the mic. Yes.
Yes, sir. I was very much fascinated by the teachers of the various branches of medicine. My experience with Professor KVT worth remembering here. I not only learned clinical medicine from him, but also many bedside manners, particularly a bit of English language. Dr. Chandra Madam was HOD in pediatric department in Stanley. She was very kind and friendly to me. Quite often, I visit her ward after finishing my OP. While I was in diabetic clinic as a paid internee, I learned pediatrics under her guidance. Till date, that experience helps me in the practice. Dr. S. Lakshmi Narayanan, at present member of Kodapang branch, in charge of diabetic clinic. When I was working under him, a wonderful teacher was my guide. He taught me many practical points in medicine. At present, I'm admitting my patients at BRS Hospital, Nungapakkam. I should not forget to mention Professor B.R. Santhanakishan sir, Director and Superintendent of ICH and HC, Professor V.S. Shankara Narayan sir, Pediatric Gastroenterologist, and Professor N. Nagajit sir, Diabetologist and Cardiologist. All are my gurus, role model, who have done a lot to me. Lastly, I cannot forget my beloved friend, my teacher and COVID warrior, Professor S. Chandrasekhar sir, who got me to this Kodapang branch. I used to visit him regularly to his residence at Nungapakkam and at SRMC. With all these practical exposure experiences and with their guidance, I am doing my practice in a village, Kutrathur, from 1978. And then I started my another clinic at Thousand Lakes from 1980. I charge my patient to those who can afford and free treatment and for free medicine for those who cannot afford. My dedicated and committed service was well appreciated by the people of Kutrathur. The most fascinating period of the time that I ever had in medical
service. Unmuted in water, end up on now.
Can you mute everybody?
I have attended many pediatric and...
Yes, sir, I'm doing it, sir.
Sir,
you please continue,
many
sir.
Pediatric and diabetic... Okay, sir. I attended many pediatric and diabetic conferences. I attended many medical camps organized by the NGOs and treating poor students with free consultation and free medicine. In that one, Home for Poor Boys, behind Government Women's House College, Anasali. And another one, second, Dazzling Stone Orphanage, Srikalathur, Kutrathur. I have conducted many free medical camps at my individual capacity and also presented participated in many free dental camps along with my two daughters, both are MDs, dental surgeon. During COVID pandemic, I gave free consultation through video chats. During 43 years of medical practice, I have come across many incidents, good, bad, and ugly. I would like to share two of them with you. One, it was about 35 years back, a 10-year-old boy came to my clinic along with his parents with acute tonsillitis. Parents told me the boy had ingested BP4 on previous day at Cropet GH, and they showed me one OPD kit also. They wanted to have 4 more to complete their course. I told him to take injection after the test dose. They insisted that no need for the test dose. I was also convinced and gave a shot of PP4. Within minutes, the boy fell down. He was sweating. Yet I just counted his pulse. It was around 50 per minute. BP was 80 per 60. I made the patient to lie down in the head down position. I kept injection adrenaline, injection avil, and IV fluids ready. Unconfidently waited for a few minutes. The boy became alright without any resuscitation, probably evasive cardiac reaction. Second one, another case, this was about 15 years back, a 45 years old man, a known peptic cancer patient came with epigastric pain. It was about 11 p.m. when I was about to close my clinic. I referred him to Higher Institute. He was not willing as it was too late. He told he would go to hospital next day and wanted some interim remedy. I checked his vitals and gave tablet pantoprazole and sucralfate gel and wrote on the prescription for immediate ECG and referred him to the Higher Institute for the corticotropin. It took place on Saturday. On Sunday was an off day. On Monday, a few police personnel came to my clinic to inquire about the person whom I treated on Saturday night. They narrated their story. That is, that man who came to me happened to be a police head constable. He had gone to hospital admitted on the same day since he was having severe pain and his ECG was being done. He had collapsed. Very massive MI. Actually, they had brought the prescription in which I have mentioned to take immediate ECG and a corticotropin. The moral of the first case, do not get panic if the patient falls down after the injection, mostly due to pain shock. Second is, when you suspect something serious, make a note of it in the OPD. Take home message. Always confidence is an asset and overconfidence is a handicap. So I sincerely thank Almighty, thank my wife, my children, esteemed teachers, cooperative colleagues, IMA Quarterback Branch, President K. Subramaniam sir, Dr. Subramaniam, Secretary Dr. Bhupati John, Treasurer Dr. Shahal Habib, LTI Award Committee members, Dr. R. Edelarsan, Dr. Muthu Perumal, and others who have directly and indirectly helped me to reach this stage. With regards to one and all, I can thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you
very
much.
Can I have a couple of words, Dr. Priya?
Of course, sir. Please, sir.
Members, Dr. Mohammad Nisar Ahmad is a very humble person who does not come out forthwith with what he is doing. Initially, when we asked for his biodata, he casually omitted all the free service he has done. But Dr. Chandrasekharan has told me about Dr. Mohammad Nisar Ahmad. And I know how much free service he has done. I know what he is doing for the society. So specifically, we sent the second letter to him, asking him for his details, what he has done during COVID period. Then he started enumerating what he has done during COVID period. So that is the man for you. He does a lot and he doesn't talk about it. Hats off to you, sir. We want to have more people like you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to our next agenda. That was very inspiring, sir. And as youngsters being in the IMA, we get to see such stalwarts and such great doctors with such humility and modesty. And I think those are all the qualities that we need as experts to imbibe you from, sir. Thank you so much for sharing your professional journey with us. And